This tutorial shows how to create and customize charts in Microsoft Word. Hello, my name is Erin. I'm a professional copy editor who shares writing tips for the real world on this channel and on my blog at erinwrightwriting.com. Charts offer a concise and visually appealing way to present numeric information. So today's tutorial explains the basics of creating and customizing charts in Microsoft Word. We'll cover five topics: how to insert a chart, how to update existing data in a chart, how to resize a chart, how to reposition a chart, and how to change chart colors. These steps apply to all 17 of Word's pre-built chart types. A few highlights are the column chart, the bar chart, and everyone's favorite, the pie chart. Please note that Word provides many ways to customize charts, many more than can reasonably be covered in one tutorial. So this tutorial presents the basic methods I believe will be most useful for the majority of users. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365, which is formerly Office 365. The steps are the same in Word 2019, Word 2016, and Word 2013. However, your interface may look slightly different in those older versions of the software. Before we begin, let's briefly discuss the terms figures, graphs, and charts. In the writing world, charts fall under the umbrella term figures, which also includes photos, drawings, maps, and musical scores. Graphs are generally considered a type of chart. Therefore, the term chart is used throughout this tutorial. However, all the steps shown here also apply to visuals typically considered to be graphs, such as line graphs. To insert a chart, begin by inserting your cursor where you want to place the chart. Then, select the Insert tab in the ribbon. From there, select the Chart button in the Illustrations group. Now, select a chart type from the left side of the Insert Chart dialog box. If you want to see a larger example of the chosen chart type, hover your pointer over the example image in the center of the dialog box. Next, select a subtype of the selected chart. The available subtypes will depend on the selected chart. Common charts such as pie charts and bar charts offer attractive 3D options. When you're finished, select the OK button to close the Insert Chart dialog box and insert the chart. If your chart is too big, select, hold, and drag one of the corner handles to resize it. We'll cover resizing in more detail later in this video. You can now enter labels and numbers into the spreadsheet by typing over the example data. Add additional labels and numbers or delete the example data as necessary. Select the X when you're ready to close the spreadsheet. Select the Chart Elements button to the right of the chart if you want to add or remove the title, data labels, or the legend. I'm going to add data labels. Note that if the right side buttons are not visible, click inside the border to select the chart. If you want to create a caption below your chart, please see my other video titled How to Insert Figure Captions and Table Titles in Microsoft Word, which is linked below. To update existing data in a chart, begin by right-clicking the chart. Then select Edit Data from the shortcut menu. Note that if you want to update your chart in Excel rather than Word spreadsheet, select the arrow next to Edit Data and select Edit Data in Excel. Edit your data in the spreadsheet, and then select the X to close the spreadsheet and apply your changes. Charts can be resized by dragging the border or by using exact dimensions such as 3 inches by 4 inches. To resize the chart by dragging the border, begin by clicking inside the border to reveal the resizing handles. Then, click and hold one of the handles as you drag the chart to the appropriate size. The corner handles provide movement in all directions, while the sides provide horizontal movement and the top and bottom provide vertical movement. To resize a chart to exact dimensions, begin by clicking inside the border to select the chart. Then select the Layout Options button to the right of the chart, followed by See More. Then select the Size tab in the Layout dialog box. If you want to maintain your chart's current shape, select Lock Aspect Ratio. Next, enter the dimensions in the Height and Width boxes. If you selected Lock Aspect Ratio, you only have to enter one of these numbers now. When you're finished, select the OK button to close the Layout dialog box and apply your new dimensions. You can customize your chart's placement on the page by changing its alignment and text wrapping. Text wrapping determines how charts are positioned in relation to the surrounding text. To begin, select the Home tab in the ribbon. Then, click inside the border to select the chart. Select the Align Left, Center, or Align Right button in the paragraph group. If you want to adjust text wrapping, select the Layout Options button to the right of the chart. The visual appeal of these options will depend on the size of your chart and the density of your surrounding text, so you may have to experiment a bit if you choose to use text wrapping. When you're finished, your position changes will be applied immediately. Now we're going to look at how to use a pre-built color palette for your whole chart and how to select custom colors for individual elements. At the end, we'll also walk through the steps for using RGB, HSL, and hex color codes. To use a pre-built color palette for your whole chart, click inside the border to select the chart. Then select the Chart Styles button to the right of the chart. Next, select the Color tab in the shortcut menu, and then choose a color palette. Your new color palette will be applied immediately. To choose custom colors for individual chart elements, select and then right-click the individual element you want to change. Then, select Fill in the shortcut menu. Now, select a color from the drop-down menu or choose More Fill Colors for additional options. Word lets you use RGB and HSL color codes in your charts. In addition, you can use hex color codes if you're using an updated version of Word for Microsoft 365, which is formerly Office 365. To begin, select and then right-click the individual chart element you want to change. Next, select Fill in the shortcut menu, followed by More Fill Colors from the drop-down menu. Select the Custom tab in the Colors dialog box. If you're going to use a hex code, enter it directly into the hex box. Or choose RGB or HSL from the Color Model menu. And then enter your RGB or HSL code in the appropriate boxes. When you're finished, select the OK button to close the Colors dialog box and apply your color change. I have created many other videos and blog posts about using figures and tables in Word, including 3 ways to insert tables in Microsoft Word. Please see the related resources section in the description box below for the complete list with links. The companion blog post for this video listing all the steps we just performed appears on erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked below. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic related to Microsoft Word or Adobe Acrobat that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel and give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.